The last moments of George Floyd's life under the knee of Officer Derek Chauvin. Listen to what Officer Chauvin says when another officer brings up excited delirium.
You're going on the side? Yeah. I just worry about the delirium or whatever.
Well, Chauvin's attorneys argue he believed George Floyd could wake up in a state called excited delirium. Although it's not recognized by the American Medical Association, 12 years ago, the American College of Emergency Physicians officially listed it as a diagnosable condition. A mental health crisis usually combined with drug use in people who get violent with police and exhibit superhuman strength. Evidence submitted to the court reveals Minneapolis police training has included recognizing excited delirium symptoms.
Stop, relax.
Yet police have come under criticism for using excited delirium as an excuse to aggressively restrain and even sedate someone. Like in the death of 23-year-old Elijah McClain in Aurora, Colorado, who had a heart attack and died days after arrest. Police put him in a neck hold, restrained him, and injected him with ketamine, claiming they believed he had excited delirium. An autopsy found McClain's cause of death as undetermined. A group of Colorado doctors have called on police and paramedics to stop sedating people with ketamine they assumed had excited delirium.
And if you have no other explanation, then you fall back on excited delirium. In the scientific literature, it is not that well described.
During the Chauvin trial, even the ER doctor in the case expressed suspicion over excited delirium.
Excited delirium, which is a controversial diagnosis.
Chauvin's defense attorney recently seemed to hint about excited delirium during cross-examination.
There are circumstances where after a person is rendered unconscious and then you perform, you revive that person, that they are more combative than they were initially.
Agreed? Yes. Yep.
A controversial medical term, but a potential factor that could come into play as Chauvin's attorney tries to save his client from a murder conviction. For The Evidence Room, I'm Jeremy Hohola.